theirs is super quick. So they're gonna be having you in. Sometimes you might only even sing for 30 seconds. If they do that, then that means that they're somewhat interested. If they usually don't do that, then that means that you might be just someone.
It was a musical audition. I didn't know.
Oh.
I thought it was an audition for like a company, entertainment company.
Oh. Halo teman-teman YouTube, selamat datang di episode kedua Mystery of K-pop teman-teman atau Mystery K-pop. Dan hari ini kita mendatangkan dua tamu yang dari episode pertama yaitu teman aku Subini dan juga Alex, yaitu former K-pop idol dan juga K-pop idol. Dan hari ini kita bakalan menjawab pertanyaan kalian mengenai audisi dan juga sebenarnya jadi K-pop trainee itu seperti apa sih. Tapi sebelum itu, before that, I want you guys to introduce yourself.
Nama saya Subin. I was originally under a group called Blady. Right now, I am currently doing YouTube under Subini. So if you guys are interested, you guys can find me there. But yeah, that's what I'm doing right now.
My name is Alex. I was in a group called High 4, and now I'm currently preparing to my music as a solo artist under Alex X or Lex or whatever you guys want to call me.
So jangan lupa untuk cek mereka out di YouTube-nya Subini dan juga Instagram-nya Alex dan juga musiknya Alex. Jadi hari ini kita bakalan ngomongin mengenai proses audisi dan juga sebagai K-pop trainee itu seperti apa sih. Jadi pertama-tama proses audisi untuk menjadi K-pop idol itu seperti apa, dan juga bagaimana sih biasanya prosesnya, dan kalau misalnya kita di accept biasanya seperti apa sih?
For me, I feel like I had a very unique audition process. Usually you have to prepare a song, a choreography, and some, any special talents you have. But most of my auditions were spontaneous. So when I first came to Korea too for my audition, they just told me to do something. So I just danced to and freestyled to a song. And then my second audition was for Loen. Same thing, like I wasn't trying to take the test, the audition, but someone recommended for me to take it. So I just did it because he was annoying me. So I went down into his basement, then they're like, what do you have prepared? I said, nothing. I just came down because he told me to. They're like, oh, well, you have to do something. I'm like, I'll dance or rap. They asked me if I could sing. I'm like, no, I can't sing. So I'm not gonna sing. And then I told him to just put down a song. I think it was like a Kanye West song, I can't remember, but I just rapped to that. And then I told him to just play any hip hop beat and I'll dance to it. Went upstairs, they called me like, yo, can you come back? Came back, they're like, all right, you're training from tomorrow, 8 a.m. Can you come to this location? I'm like, what just happened? Did I just become a trainee?
Wow,
like, I wasn't trying to.
Wow.
But then third time, how I got to High 4 was like same thing. After I left Loen, because just personal reasons, it just didn't match.
Yeah.
I got a phone call. They're like, my mom actually called me. She's like, hey, this is audition. Come to this location within 30 minutes. I was like, what? And I had nothing. So I just went. Same thing happened there too.
Wow, they found talent all three times. They saw you.
Funny thing,
you never got rejected. Like, let me tell you the story about how to get rejected during auditions.
Because I got rejected a lot.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's so crazy.
The third time, it was a musical audition. I didn't know.
Oh.
I thought it was an audition for like a company, entertainment company.
Oh.
But then, so there was like this line. I'm like, okay, I had nothing prepared again. And then I was the last person because I came late. And then I did it, and then I left. And then the same thing called, like, can you come back inside? I'm like, oh, okay. And then all the judges were like, actually, this is a musical audition. I'm like, oh, sorry. I don't know why I'm here. Oh, someone just called me and told me to come here, so I just saw the audition. Like, yeah, but, and then one of the people was actually the CEO of my company. He was like, I'm actually making a group called High 4. I want you to be a part of it and take part. And then we talked after, and then I became a trainee.
What about you?
Must be nice.
For me, after the K-pop Star season 2 auditions, and I did the auditions in Korea, I didn't pass, unfortunately. So for me, I started to do the typical monthly auditions or like the weekly auditions that are held in Korea. If you guys ever come to Korea, there is going to be different companies that do auditions at the end of the month, or it depends for each company. But that is what I did. I went the very generic way of doing the auditions, and then I was doing the auditions for the company now, and I got in through auditions as well. But for me, I think I did like 8 auditions, and I would always go up to like the first, second round, and I never got to like the final round. So for me, I think that was like a good experience to do a lot of auditions as well. It's Alex has like, you know, like a miracle story where he could kind of do just like get in each time, but I feel like for people who want to audition as well, it is always going to be a good experience even though you might not make it. So yeah, if you guys are ever interested, I'd highly recommend it.
Wait, I'm gonna go a little bit more technical. So like, how does it work? Do you apply first, or there's a form, or you sign up online, and then after that, like, you just go?
So each entertainment has like a Twitter or like a homepage, and then they'll say, okay, for this week, we're going to be doing on the third week of the month, and it's going to be on a Saturday, held at 1 to 5 around this time. And basically, you go to the entertainment and then you sign a form. So they're going to be passing out forms with papers, and you're just waiting in line with a bunch of people who are trying to audition, and then they take you in by like 10. So, or like 10 or 5, or there could be like individuals, but usually if it's like a big company, there's just too many people auditioning. So you're just gonna be writing a form, and then they'll put you in groups of 10, and then everybody just does their act for like a minute or two. You could either sing, dance, rap, or act, model, and then from there, if they are interested, they might do like some camera angles and be like, look straight, look to the side, smile.
Right.
You know,
and do they record video as well?
Yeah, they do. Oh. So that's a good sign. If they do that, then that means that they're somewhat interested. If they usually don't do that, then that means that you might be just someone that
if they ask you to do something, that means they're interested.
Yeah, if they ask you for even another song, that means they're interested. So highly recommend having one or two songs prepared, because you might be always put on the spot, you know? Or you could just be like Alex, like, just turn on any song for me, and then, you know, go with the audition there too.
But usually, yeah, I've actually judged an audition before, and I've seen a lot of people nowadays, they only prepare one thing, like one song, or just one dance, or just one thing. And when I was training, like when I saw the people audition, like, it's best to come prepared with more than one song. It's best to have a song. It's even better to have a song and a choreo, and having extra talents to show. Because if you show, like, I have this one song per day, and they ask you for a dance, like, oh, I can't dance, then it's like, I mean, I did that, but like, it's better not to do that. You have a better image, like, oh, this guy is prepared, he's ready to go.
Yeah.
Like, then they know, like, oh, this guy has potential. But if they see that you have to build you up from the ground up, that's more work for them. So you have to show that you have potential than, oh, like, this guy already has it down somewhat.
Yeah.
So it's better to show what you can do, like show your potential.
For me, I've done a weekly audition, a monthly audition, and also a global audition. So I've done a lot of auditions. They're all different. So SM usually does weekly auditions. They are held at COEX. So if you guys ever want to audition, you guys can audition there. And basically, theirs is super quick. So they're going to be having you in. Sometimes you might only even sing for 30 seconds. If not, they might just be like, oh, 감사합니다. They might stop you in between if they don't see the type of potential. Because I've seen, I think at SM auditions, I've seen around like at least like 300. Global auditions are a lot more. They have like a huge convention center, or like they would have like a school auditorium, and I've seen around like thousands for global auditions. So for monthly auditions, I think it's a little bit different. There is a timing that you can go from like 1 through 5, so everybody comes at a time that's more convenient for them. So I think that for me, usually it was around at least, if the max was like 100 people, and yeah, I think that that's pretty much the difference between all these evaluations or like the auditions.
Yeah, for me, I've seen other besides like the public open audition, people have, a lot of companies do a lot of private auditions where those certain kids are connected. They gather kids that are through mutual people around them.
Oh, like recommended.
Yeah, so recommended. Like, oh, maybe a friend of a friend knows this person in this company, and they recommend this kid. Then they would gather like maybe a good 5, 10, 20 of those kids and have a private audition for those kids.
Does this apply to like a bigger companies or like general
companies? All companies, small or big.
Yeah, or there'll be like auditions. You know, casting managers who might be casting people out in the streets too, and those will be private auditions as well. But then I think it's just always varies with the different types of auditions.
Kira-kira kayak di stage terakhirnya ada kayak lebih detailnya nggak, Subin?
I think that for me there was, I would say for most company it's like first audition, second audition, and then the final auditions. So for the first auditions, it is usually with a bunch of people, and you're gonna be performing a song for maybe under a minute. Usually no like MR in the background, it's just your voice, because they don't wanna be sidetracked with different sounds. And if you're gonna be dancing, they might just have a song prepared, because a lot of people prepare
choreo, and they want to see just like a freestyle type of dance. And then if you make it to the second round, it is going to be a little bit more private. So you're going to be seeing a lot of the company people, like the casting managers, and they're going to be seeing the types of potentials you have. They might ask you to do a lot more things, or they might ask you to prepare a song with the MR for the second round. And they're going to be doing camera test angles to see what you could do. And then for the third one, you're going to be meeting kind of like the top people, like the CEO. So if you were to audition for YG and, you know, JYP, you're going to be seeing like Park Jin-young himself for the third round. And that is when they make the final evaluation to see if you can become a trainee. And I think those are like the very basic steps that you take. So I would say around like 3 times of auditions to become a trainee.
Wow. So for like bigger companies, I feel like those steps are taken to filter, because a lot of people take those auditions, so they do that to cut down on who to pick. So that's like stage one, alright, we got like maybe like 50 people. Stage two, alright, let's cut it down to half. And then stage three, alright, let's get it to like a good 5 people. That's how you get filtered through. That's why you always have to be prepared with like songs you're good at.
Okay, teman-teman, untuk pertanyaan yang terakhir ini aku juga penasaran ya guys. Jadi aku pengen nanya, apakah kayak core quality-nya untuk menjadi seorang trainee? Jadi apa sih yang sebenarnya perusahaan-perusahaan itu lihat kalau misalnya kalian audisi, dan juga biasanya semua proses ini tuh kira-kira berapa lama sih?
You first?
So first, usually they a normal group has consists of like maybe a visual, a dancer, a vocal, a rapper. So then they would probably pick someone who stands out in one of those aspects. So you must be like very good at rapping, or an amazing dancer, or amazing vocalist, or just ridiculously good looking. Like if you stand out in one of those aspects or excel in one aspect, then they'll think like, you know what, we can, if he's like a dancer, like, you know what, we can help him, train him to sing, and train him to rap or whatnot. But then whatever he's good at, that's what they're gonna make him be. Like, he's gonna be the main dancer.
I also have like a different take on this too. There are many trainees where they could just see potential. These casting managers have seen so many trainees from them being like not being able to dance at all to a point where they do so good. So I think that these casting managers, they definitely look for potential and also confidence, because if you are gonna be with all these trainees, you have to be confident in what you do. They want to, you know, see that, because a K-pop idol as well, you need to have the confidence on stage. You're not gonna be like, you're not doing a song. So I think that those are the core qualities for characteristics for the auditions.
Wow. Yeah, potential is very important.
Yeah.
Thank you guys so much for coming for this video. Dan untuk teman-teman yang penasaran, kita bakalan ada segmen lagi satu di mana kita bakalan ngomongin mengenai setelah kita jadi trainee itu prosesnya seperti apa sih sebelum debut. Jadi jangan lupa untuk stay tune ke episode 3, and jangan lupa untuk support Alex and Subin di Instagram dan juga YouTube mereka. So yeah, I'll see you guys next time.